I think e-bikes are awesome. Like I've kind of been excited to ride one for years now, and now with Intense and the new Tazer, it was instantly just a piece of my training arsenal that I ride every week now, all the time for a lot of different things. My training, like personally, week to week, it's kind of been a game changer for me because I like to be in the dirt and be out here riding and stuff, but with the amount of training we put in the gym and on the downhill bike and all that stuff, a lot of times you're doing recovery rides and stuff like that. So in the past, a recovery ride was me having to get on a road bike and go out through traffic and ride that. But now I can come out here to somewhere like this and I can have a full-on recovery day, like on the mountain bike trails that I like, and I can just turn the boost mode on the bike and there's a 20-minute climb. It can just be a spin. So it just gives me a lot more options on where I ride with my training rides.
The part of training that I like and why I haven't never stopped doing it, and I even remember prior to turning professional in racing, there was something about it I really enjoyed, just getting out there on the bike, cycling, the physical side, and just maintaining a healthy lifestyle. For me, it wasn't just to be a fit athlete, it was to maintain that lifestyle, and it, ultimately it's enjoyable and get out and go in the hills or whatever it may be, just to kind of experience that, kind of a health and wellness aspect of it. I want to live a long time, I want to try to maintain a healthy lifestyle, but ultimately just the fun factor. I do like to suffer a little bit, and have a good time.
I grew up racing motocross, and my sort of dream as a kid was always to be like race supercross and all that kind of stuff. And then when I started in downhill, I've obviously stayed pretty heavily involved with motocross, and I still ride a lot and train, and I love it. And I got a lot of friends and people in that industry and sort of vice versa, so the crossover is pretty cool. So it's cool for me because Ryan was definitely a dude that I looked up to a lot as a racer throughout his career. I mean, everybody knows what he's accomplished and everything, and so it's pretty cool now to be able to ride with him and kind of just hang out and chat and kind of develop a little bit of a friendship.
I've gotten to know Aaron, actually I just met him back in December for the first time. I knew a little bit about his background. I know he was as a downhill mountain biker. I saw him on YouTube and stuff, and the guy is, I hear a lot about him and he's impressive, and then lately seen his GoPros. So to be able to, kind of for me, this is a cool opportunity to be able to ride together with him and jump into his world and learn a little bit more, experience a little bit more, and ultimately kind of work together. It's pretty special. In eco mode, which is the least power to the pedals, and turns out he was in boost mode. I was trying to figure out why I couldn't keep up with him.
Because the top is all blown out. I'm like, dude, you're gonna put it in boost mode? He's like, no. It's like, I yelled it out. I'm just cranking gears over here.
Been sitting in the cold too long. Need to work on my fitness.